I can't keep my eyes open.
I found these two little things that looked like little chocolate chips, and after smelling it, it's definitely not chocolate chips.
I woke up with the absolute worst bags under my eyes, and this eye is like swollen. I can't even open it all the way.
I have never felt so defeated.
Good morning. It is Monday, March the 13th. It never ceases to amaze me that no matter how much sleep I catch up on over the weekend, I'm still really, really tired on Monday morning, but it's okay because I had a fantastic weekend. I barely did anything school-related, which I definitely needed. I spent a lot of time with my boyfriend, and I slept a lot, and I ate a lot of food, and it was just a really good weekend. So I do feel re-energized for the week, but at the same time, I'm like not looking forward to it because the month of March is a really long month. We don't have a single day off, and it's killing me. We have another 3 weeks with full 5 day weeks, and I'm just not excited about it. Like, I need a day off, I need a 4 day week to look forward to. But if I can survive March, the month of April should fly by, and then May should fly by, and then it's basically the end of the school year. So I'm gonna go grab my coffee, and I will catch up with you guys once I get to school.
Good morning, may I take your order?
Good morning, can I get a medium iced coffee with the vanilla swirl and almond milk, please?
Anything else?
Nope, that will be it.
It's going to be $2.53.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So it's totally normal to get a nice coffee when it's 25 degrees out, right?
All right, it's 8:10 now. I got here around 8 o'clock, swiped in, made a couple last-minute copies, heated up my breakfast, so I am now ready to go. Thankfully, I don't have to check homework this morning, so I can connect the iPads and get some stuff ready for science. And fingers crossed that the cold weather and the full moon does not make my students' behavior unbearable.
Till I get up, time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left.
It is now lunchtime. The morning has gone okay with the exception of Knuckles. He's in a horrible mood because he had to owe half of his recess from being on Teacher's Choice on Friday. And he's mad at me about it. I'm like, look, it's your choice. You decided to get on Teacher's Choice on Friday. This is your consequence. Like, sorry, not sorry. But good news is the day is halfway over. I have special this afternoon, which should help that go by faster. And I don't have to do any planning tonight, which takes off a lot of the stress. So fingers crossed, he will be in a better mood when I go to pick him up from lunch and the afternoon can go by smoothly. All right, it is now my afternoon special time. It has been a little bit of a rough afternoon. My kids have been very chatty, which isn't horrible, like I can put up with that, but Knuckles ended up getting sent out because he was being extremely, extremely disrespectful, and that's one thing that I just don't tolerate. If I'm respectful towards you, I expect the same thing in return. However, good news is, during this planning time, I actually get to get grading done because I don't have any planning to do and my room is pretty clean, so I can work strictly on grading, and then that way I will not have to stay too late after school.
So I get my friend's paper back, who I had sent out of my room, and it just tells me how dumb I am and how much he hates me. Isn't that lovely? And I'm not even going to show it to you, but earlier during Daily 5, I found these two little things that looked like little chocolate chips at one of my student seats, and I cleaned it up with these tissues, and after smelling it, it's definitely not chocolate chips.
And we'll go through the wastelands, through the highway. Till my shadow turns to sun rays, and on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, and on.
The day, and quite a few things have transpired since I last recorded. Number one, I had an email from Montgomery County, which that's the county I'm going to be moving to in Maryland, and it was about setting up a screening interview, so kind of like a pre-interview for the actual interviews. Thankfully, they were able to set up a FaceTime interview, so I don't have to take off school and drive all the way up there. They will be able to do it just over the phone with my iPhone and FaceTime. So that is scheduled currently for March 29th, so I have a couple of weeks to get prepared for that. I honestly honestly have no idea what it's even going to entail because I've never done like a screening interview before. So we shall see. If you've done one, please let me know in the comments what kinds of questions were asked because I have no clue. Second, I had an email from one of the ladies who observed me like a week or two ago, whenever that was, about setting up a conference to go over it tomorrow during my planning time. So I'm like super nervous. Like as soon as I read the email, my stomach just dropped because I'm just nervous that it's going to be like critiques and not positive things, but fingers crossed that it is positive. I also had to handle an issue with a parent who's upset with another parent and I just don't have time for that. But it is about 3:45. I'm going to get out of here because I'm fully planned for tomorrow. I do need to go run a couple of errands to get things for a STEM project, but other than that, I am all ready for tomorrow, which is fantastic. I'm gonna enjoy the night to myself, work on stuff for TPT, and I will catch up with you guys later. Wednesday, March the 14th. I'm running really, really late. It is already 7:45 and I'm just now leaving. I stayed up until 2 a.m. working on my editable spelling list, which was a bad idea because I slept in really late this morning because I was super tired, but it's okay. I'm gonna go get some coffee, get to school. It will all work out okay. Alright, I don't have long to vlog because I do have a student coming for lunch brunch, and then I'm not going to be able to vlog during my planning time today because I have to meet with my supervisor and the other lady who was here for my observation like a week and a half ago. However, the day has been pretty crazy. Their behavior isn't like horrible, it's just it's pouring down rain outside and it's nasty, and I'm super jealous of everyone that's getting snow right now because we are not, and it's just kind of one of those days where I'm just like, eh, like I want to go home and take a nap really bad. So this morning I did have guidance and that gave me time to get this game prepped for math on Friday. All I did was just hot glue a gold coin onto a green popsicle stick, and then I just put addition and subtraction plus and minus 10 facts on these, and it's a game kind of like Kaboom if you've ever played Kaboom. So there are 5 sticks that say unlucky on them like this, and if a student pulls that stick they have to put all of their sticks back. Thankfully, we did have indoor recess today, so that allowed me to get all of my Tuesday folders stuffed and ready to go since I'm not going to be able to do it during my planning today. So we are going to attempt to record this without crying because I'm just extremely upset. Obviously, I met with the lady. She's a supervisor of reading for the county. I met with her for my observation, and I have never felt so defeated as a teacher. First of all, right before I met with her, I went into the bathroom and completely shattered the front of my phone. And right now, I honestly could care less about that because that doesn't even matter to me right now. It's the fact that I feel like a horrible teacher and I know that I'm not one. I know 100% that I'm not a bad teacher, but I feel like I was made to feel like one during the meeting. I think what frustrates me the most is the fact that I spend countless hours on the weekends and after school, and I spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars in my classroom, and I'm literally dedicating every part of my life to teaching. And to feel like I'm inadequate is just not a good feeling, especially when the things that were critiqued to me were things that just don't matter, at least in my opinion. Like, I don't see how it affects things. One of the things that I was highly critiqued for that they were so upset over is that one of my students was kneeling instead of sitting during the guided reading lesson. First of all, I have 5 stools for the table because I don't have any extra chairs in my room, so I have 5 stools that I personally have purchased with my own money, and I do have 2 groups that have 6 students. Those students, if all the stools are gone, they're responsible for bringing up their own chair to the table. That student chose not to do it. I didn't notice because they're sitting on the opposite side of the table. I can't see below, like, here on them, and they chose to kneel, and to me, I'm like, what does it matter if they're sitting or kneeling or standing? As long as they're comfortable, I don't see how it matters. I mean, maybe that's just my opinion, but to me, what matters is the fact that the student's comfortable and that they're learning. That student was learning. I don't see how it matters that they chose not to sit in a stool or a chair. And to me, it's the fact that I feel like teachers are just so... It's just so defeating when you feel like they come into your classroom for these observations and it's like they're literally looking for things to critique you on and things that they need to bring up that are negative. And I just don't like that. Like, I really don't. You know, we're supposed to, with our students, focus on the positives, and, you know, we're a PBIS school and all that. And it's like, well, why don't we do that with the teachers? And, you know, not all observations are like that. And my administration hasn't necessarily been like that. But this observation, which this is like the first time I've really even met this lady, I don't know, it's just extremely, extremely defeating. And honestly, it makes me feel like, why am I putting in the extra time and the extra money when it doesn't matter and it's not recognized? Like, why? And yes, I do it for my kids, but at the same time, like, it would be nice to feel like it's appreciated and that it's noticed by, you know, administrators or supervisors or whatever. And I am not one to cry, especially in front of people. Like, I don't cry in front of people. And when I was sitting down talking with her, I literally was starting to cry at the end because it felt like it was just one negative thing after another, after another, after another. And it's like, I don't know. I've just never felt so low before as a teacher, to be completely honest. And like, I started crying at the end and she's like, well, what's bothering you? And I said, like, I'm a perfectionist and like, I know there's things that I'm trying to get better at and I'm working on it. But, you know, I said, like, I explained to her, I said, I feel like, you know, you come in for an observation and you only see a very small part of the day. And when you come in, like, I feel very thrown off. I feel very nervous. They were in there for my whole entire lunch. Like, I didn't even get to eat that day. And I just feel like that's not taken into context. And I don't know. but anyway, so I ended up leaving school like right at 3:45. Like, I literally had my bag ready to go. So as soon as my last kid was dismissed, like, I left because I just didn't even want to be there anymore, to be completely honest. Like, I wanted to leave. And I right now feel completely unmotivated, like, for the rest of the week, if we're being completely honest. And I'm trying to be positive, and I'm sure I'll feel better later after I've had some time to, like, reflect and relax and get it off my mind. But right now, I just feel so unmotivated. But I have to get myself together because tonight is McTeacher's Night at McDonald's, so the teachers go in and work, and I'm working from 6 to 7. And honestly, like, I don't even want to go right now, and I was so excited. But I have to suck it up. I have to go take a shower so that I can leave on time. So I will catch up with you guys after. Life update. It is 5:30. I'm about to head to McDonald's for McTeacher night and go deliver some food to some tables. I am done having a pity party. I have realized that I have 2 choices. I can be a thermometer or I can be a thermostat. So a thermometer reacts to the environment around it, while a thermostat is in control of the environment around it. So I can either react to the situation and let it affect me negatively, or I can be in control of the situation and realize that, you know what, I don't need an observation on a piece of paper to tell me that I'm a good teacher. I don't need someone who met me for the first time and spent 1 hour in my room on one particular day of the school year to tell me that I'm a good teacher. I know the time that I put in, I know the effort that I put in, and I know the passion that I put in. And I know that I'm good at what I do, despite someone else's opinion. And I know that I've made a difference in several of my students' lives, and that's all that matters to me. So I'm gonna just let it go. I'm gonna move on. I'm going to take it with a grain of salt, work on the things that I need to work on, and get better in time,
For now, I need to go deliver some food to some tables at McDonald's. I will catch up with you guys after.
All right, it is 7 o'clock. I am finally done. I am very, very tired. And if I do not have a voice tomorrow, it's because I have been shouting out orders for the past hour. However, I enjoyed the time. I enjoyed seeing my kids. It was a good time. Well worth it. I am now headed to the grocery store because they just started carrying my favorite brand of high protein ice cream that I cannot get anywhere within like a 2-hour radius of me. And they just started carrying it. So I'm going to go get some. And that is going to be the thing that I do for myself this week. I'm going to eat the entire thing and I'm not going to feel guilty about it. And we'll grow in number, fueled by them to see the horizon, turn us to thousands. Good morning. It is Wednesday, the 15th of March. I don't know why I worded it like that. But number one, I only ate like a third of one of the pints of ice cream. I don't know why I thought I could eat the whole thing. Number two, I fell asleep on the couch at 9:30 last night because I was so exhausted, physically and emotionally exhausted. And number three, I woke up with the absolute worst bags under my eyes. And this eye is like swollen. I can't even open it all the way. What the heck? I did not need this right now whatsoever. I am about to head to my PLC meeting. It's like 7:20. I might get a large coffee because I can literally barely keep my eyes open right now, despite the fact that I went to bed hours before I usually do. So I am a little bit upset about that, but hopefully coffee helps and hopefully it's a good day because I'm honestly just kind of over this week. And I know I'm really positive usually and I'm trying to be, but I just need a weekend really, really badly. All right, guys, apparently today is not my day. This was so embarrassing. I was going through the Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru and all of a sudden I realized that my window wouldn't roll down, I guess because it's so cold outside. So I had to like open my door in order to place my order and then I had to do the same thing in order to pay and get my coffee. And I'm just so done right now.
All right, life update. It is 11 a.m. I am still so tired. I can't keep my eyes open. My left eye is still swollen and I can't even open it all the way. And the morning has just been a hot mess and I can't even blame it on my kids. Like, yes, they've been talkative, but it's definitely like my fault today because I just do not have my life together and I have no patience and it's just not a good day for me whatsoever. But my students are currently at PE. We had to switch PE time today. Usually it's in the afternoon, but today we have it in the morning because there's like a testing schedule going on or something. I don't even know. But the good news is right after PE, we will have indoor recess and the PE teachers are gonna let us have indoor recess in the gym, which is great because my kids can be as loud as they want. They can run around, get some energy out. I'm honestly just trying to survive until the end of the day at this point.
So I should probably be spending my planning time grading since I did not do any grading yesterday. However, that is the absolute last thing that I feel like doing right now. So instead, I'm going to spend a little bit of time attaching these labels to the bags of Lucky Charms that you saw me prep earlier in the week. This is a freebie that I found on Pinterest. I have no idea where I actually downloaded it from. I will try to link it in the description. So I'm just going to attach these over top of the white cardstock with these glue dots. I think these came from Dollar Tree. I don't even know if they're still sticky because I'm pretty sure I bought them like months ago, but still. So this is the one thing I'm doing for my students this week for the teacher three. I'm gonna give them the bag of Lucky Charms on Friday. And it kind of works out as well for math because we are gonna use the bags of Lucky Charms to graph the marshmallow shapes as one of our math rotations. So just in time for the end of my planning, I have gotten all of the tags glued on to the Lucky Charms bags, so I'm all ready to go for Friday. So to add to the list, during indoor recess in the gym, one of my kids' glasses got broken, so I now get to pretend that I'm an optometrist and attempt to fix them. So I did make it until dismissal, and thankfully because of our PLC meeting this morning, my students are in another classroom for dismissal, so that gives me time to myself to try to get stuff done. So I need to get Tuesday folders entered in the computer. I need to clean up my entire desk area. I need to go through papers and grade them, plus papers from yesterday I still need to grade. So this happened today. This student, instead of cutting out the words and gluing them in, decided to write his own in. So I have a herd of mammoths, and I mean technically he's not wrong, and a pack of Tyrannosaurus rexes. So talk about irony. Yesterday I dropped my phone and it cracks and shatters, and then today I get a text message from Verizon talking about how I can get a new phone. So for the Teacher 3 this week, the one thing I am doing for my classroom is going to be cleaning out these desk drawers. Now the top one is actually pretty organized and clean. That one's not really a concern. However, this one that I can't even open all the way because there's like a hammer back here that gets stuck. This is where I put everything that I don't feel like dealing with, including this is the ice pack that I give my kids. This came from the dollar store. Y'all, it's not even cold. I just keep it in my desk and give it to my kids when they complain of something hurting instead of sending them to the nurse. But this is a hot mess that I need to take care of. And I also need to go through this bottom drawer. And this is where I keep like candy, Rice Krispie treats, along with other just random crap that I have, to be completely honest. But I'm a little bit scared to go through here because this is the drawer where that chocolate bar was last week that got eaten by some kind of critter. So goodness knows what I'm gonna find. Clean desk drawers is now complete. I'd already showed you that this drawer was pretty much organized, so that one I didn't have to do. My second drawer, it's a lot better. I know it still doesn't look like great, but right now this is as good as it's gonna get. So I showed you guys this bag in my What's in Your Teacher Bag video. I used to keep it in my teacher bag, but it got too full, so now I keep it in here. But this just has small toiletry items. This is the ice pack that I give my kids. I leave it right here at the front of the drawer, that way my kids can open up and grab it. These are assorted colored pointers that I got from the Target dollar spot like a year or two ago, and for whatever reason I felt the need to get every single color, and that was a horrible decision because now I don't know what to do with them. And then underneath, I have some random, like, screwdrivers and hammers that I brought to my classroom, and I'm just gonna leave them here just in case I need them. Here, I have a plethora of random notebooks, so if you need a notebook, let me know, because I have, like, 50. These are random, like, freebies that I've gotten over the years that have post-it notes in them. And right now I don't need them, so I'm just going to kind of keep them in there. This container has random odds and ends, things like batteries, small light bulbs, screws, little hooks, sticky tack. So I'm just going to keep that all in there. My bottom drawer is mostly like my prize type of drawer. I do have a treasure box that I keep like way back there in the back of my room, but these are like smaller things. So this container has all of my candy. My students get a piece of candy if they make it to Super Student for the day. This one has all of my Rice Krispie treats. I give those to my students who either get A's on tests or who show a big improvement from their previous test. Random extension cord, I have nowhere else to put it. And then these are like, I don't know, just random stuff that I had in my drawer, like little fun erasers, little packs of stickers, leftover teeth from Halloween. So I threw it all in this basket, and I think what I'm gonna do is let my students who make it to the very tippy top of my clip chart, normally when that happens, I will actually clip them onto my lanyard for the day. Oh crap, I just realized I need to still put in dojo points. Anyway, if they make it up to the top of my chart, I'm gonna start letting them pick one of the items from there so I can get rid of some of this crap. But good news is I did not find any like mice or little critters, which is fantastic. However, whatever it was must have really liked Kit Kat bars, even better than the Hershey's chocolate, because there's like a whole Kit Kat bar that is completely missing from this. Although apparently they were not hungry enough to need a Snickers because this one is completely untouched. It is 6 o'clock. I am ready to get out of here because I am still so exhausted. I never woke up today. I am pretty sure I may have taught part of the day with my eyes closed. Totally kidding. Possibly serious. I am gonna stop at the Verizon store. I'm sorry, guys. I'm like so tired. It's not even funny. I'm gonna stop at the Verizon store on the way home and just inquire about getting a new phone. Probably won't actually get one tonight, but the cracked screen is driving me crazy. And there's like this black blob on the right-hand side that's like inching its way towards the center, and it's getting bigger and bigger by the hour. So I feel like I at least need to be ready to get a new phone when the time comes. However, I'm hesitant about getting an iPhone 7 because it doesn't have a headphone jack, and that just makes me nervous. I know you can get an adapter, but that's more money, and I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I do know that I'm gonna try to get to bed early tonight, although I feel like that did me no good last night, so maybe I just should stay up late again and see if I go back to normal. I don't know. We'll see, but I will catch up with you guys later. So apparently I totally lied when I said I wasn't going to get a new phone. It ended up being cheaper than I thought because I was eligible for an upgrade. So I am the proud new owner of a brand new iPhone 7 in the matte black, which I'm super excited about. Matte black is my jam. And I went with the largest size. I think it's like 256 gigs because I have a ton of stuff on my phone. Plus, I went ahead and got a LifeProof case. So hopefully this does not happen again. And I also went ahead and sprung for insurance. I also came home to some happy mail. I have a package from Amazon and another package from Amazon, which my cat is currently claiming. So this is one of the things I got. I know it seems totally random, but I got these small black like kettles or cauldrons or pots. Basically, we're gonna use this for a math game on Friday. I am going to assign each cauldron a certain number of points, and my students are gonna throw gold coins, and whichever pots the gold coins land in, they will have to add together those points. Good morning. It is Thursday, March the 16th. I am really tired. I struggled to get up this morning. It's already 7:40, so I need to get going. However, last night I did officially register as an LLC, which is very exciting. I'm gonna go get some coffee so I can get through the day, and I will catch up with you guys at school. So today's one of those days where I feel like we are just taking test after test after test. My students took a math test this morning and a language test, and we still need to do our comprehension check and our vocabulary quiz, but that way it's out of the way and done so we can do fun stuff tomorrow. But the good news is we had indoor recess, plus I showed my students a video during social studies. I got all of the math tests graded, all of the language tests graded. I've entered them in the grade book, so now I just need to go put them by the mailboxes. Also, one of my dojo prizes that my students can buy with their dojo points is taking my chair for the day. So this student spent 50 of their dojo points to take my chair. So I now am currently sitting in a kid chair for the day. All right, it is lunchtime, and honestly, the morning hasn't been that bad, knock on wood, but we took a math test first thing this morning, and then if they finished early, they worked on this, like, addition, sum, coloring page, whatever. It was just to keep them occupied, and then we took a language test, and then for social studies, we watched a video on Helen Keller. So it was one of the animated hero classics. They're, like, half-an-hour-long videos, and they're, like, biographies. You can find them on Discovery Education if your school belongs to that. So my students have never sat so quietly during a video because they are so into learning about Helen Keller. Honestly, none of my kids really knew anything about her before we started learning about her, and they are so engaged, and I love it. Like, I love when they're interested in something because I could spend so much longer on it when I know that they, like, really want to learn more, and it makes my teacher heart super happy. So I'm gonna go sit and enjoy my lunch. I don't need to grade anything. I'm all caught up in grading, which is such a good feeling. So I did have someone bring by my gift from my secret pal earlier today, and to be honest, I totally have not even had time to go through it until now. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I got. So the first thing you can obviously see sticking out are these fresh flowers, which I'm really excited about because I never buy fresh flowers, but I do think they're really pretty and they smell amazing. So I haven't decided yet if I'm gonna leave these in my classroom or if I'm gonna take them home with me, but I do think that they are absolutely beautiful. All right, so this is my card with my clue as to who my secret pal is. And then I have this container, which I am in love with this container. I love the gold top. Let's see. Oh, great. Just what I need, a whole bunch of chocolate. But I'm not gonna lie, I'm really excited about this. These are like some Russell Stover candies and Rolos, which I absolutely love. I love caramel. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, like, these are probably not gonna make it until the end of the week. I probably shouldn't eat them, but I'm going to. All right, so next thing, I can't lie, I am super excited about these. It is a thing of pistachios, and to make it even better, they're the ones that have already been picked out of the shells, and I love pistachios. I love all nuts, but they're so expensive, so I don't buy them very often, so I'm really excited about these. I will definitely keep these in my classroom as a go-to snack. All right, I also got this chocolate bar, which again, probably shouldn't eat it, but probably will eat it. All right, and the last thing are these bracelets, and I have a pretty good idea. I think I know who my secret pal is, but these are absolutely gorgeous. I don't own a lot of bracelets. I don't wear them very often, but I absolutely love this color of blue, and it's gold, so I absolutely love these. All right, my students are now at music. It is my afternoon special. It's about 1. I dropped them off at 1:30. I think it's about 1:40 now. I have to go pick them up at 2 o'clock. So this is a short special day. It's only a half an hour long, and now I only have like 20 minutes left. So I'm going to use this time to get materials out for our STEM project. My students are building a leprechaun trap, and they were supposed to do it yesterday, but they were talking all day, and we ran out of time. And I kind of don't feel like they deserve it today either. Like, they have been super talkative, but at the same time, I do want to be able to see them do it. I love seeing what they create, and I love doing STEM projects. So honestly, I want to do it because I want to just see them, like, interact with the materials and see what they come up with. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the materials ready because we're not gonna have a ton of time to get it done. So I want to try to be as efficient as possible. All right, so I've laid out all the materials for their STEM project. I have cardboard pieces, construction paper, toilet paper tubes, tape, index cards, toothpicks, craft sticks, straws, yarn, paper cups, and then glue, and I have both glue sticks and liquid glue.
This in the front.
This is a door.
I made the door.
Okay. All right. So how are you gonna trap the leprechaun?
We're gonna make him come in the house, and then it's gonna be like
in the back.
How are you gonna lure him into the house?
What you mean?
Lure means like, how are you gonna get him to go in there on his own?
We're gonna use gold.
Okay.
Coin.
So how are you guys going to trap the leprechaun?
We're gonna use a bridge. Then once he crosses,
and we're gonna trap him like this too. Okay.
We're gonna hang it over this.
I don't agree.
Okay.
More tape. Some on the side.
So what are all those cups there for?
Oh, so I'm gonna put a bucket right here.
Where are you getting a bucket from?
Oh, that's easy.
Oh, that's easy?
I'm going to make a bucket. I need some yarn.
Okay, fifth grade.
All right, so how are you making a bucket?
We need paper thread.
Cut off what you don't need. All right, so we did not finish the STEM project. We probably only got about halfway through it, but the good thing is we were able to get cleaned up, and my tables have been wiped down with wet wipes, and I feel so much better. So I had one group put all their stuff in this bin, one group put all their stuff in this bin, and then I used some of the bins that I sometimes use for math. There's one over there with one group's stuff. One group is here. These are all the extra materials that I'm leaving out just in case a group needs more. This is another group, and then this is the hot mess of one of my students who decided to work alone. All right, it's 3:45 on the nose, and I'm getting out of here. I stayed late last night, and I don't typically do that on Wednesdays, so I'm getting out of here ASAP tonight. I'm gonna head straight to the gym, and I will catch up with you guys later. Good morning, it is Friday, March the 17th. It is St. Patrick's Day. I'm a little bit nervous for today because it is a non-cap day for my students. We only have those like maybe 3 times a year. It's not very often at all. So cap is consistent attire program. It's kind of like uniform, but a little bit different. Basically, they have to wear a polo shirt and then they have to wear either pants, a jumper or a skirt, no jeans, and it has to be either white, black, light blue, dark blue, gray, or yellow. And my students are able to wear whatever they want today, so long as it is school appropriate. And because my students don't get to do that very often, it just kind of throws the whole day off. But good news is our local fire department is coming this morning to read a book to the kids. Bad news is, and guys, this is why I don't plan in advance, like it always ends up coming back to bite me. I had all those fun math stations planned for today, and I'm not gonna have time to do them. I had to narrow it down just to 2, so we're gonna do Lucky Charms graphing, and then we're gonna do the unlucky stick pull game that I showed you guys earlier this week, because I glued those gold coins on the popsicle sticks, so you better believe they are gonna get used. I'm gonna go get to school. I will show you my outfit, and I will catch up with you guys once I get there. Hi, good morning. Can I get a medium vanilla latte with almond milk, please, hot? All right, I just got to school. It's about 7:30, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you my outfit for today. First, I have these shamrock earrings. These came from Walmart, I think like 2 or 3 years ago. I have this Lucky to Be a Teacher shirt. This came from Amazon. I have these shamrock leggings from Walmart, and then black boots. I mentioned earlier how our local fire department is coming today to read a book to the kids, and they're gonna announce the winner from this reading program that they've done. So we're gonna have them read How to Catch a Leprechaun. This is a really cute book if you haven't already grabbed it. I know it's a newer book, but I got it for like $1 off of Scholastic. I just laid out all of the Lucky Charms bags at their seats. Now the difficult part is getting them to wait to eat them until the math activity. So I made these last year. They've been sitting in my March bucket, but these are for all my students who don't have green. I just printed them right onto labels, so they're a sticker I can stick on their shirt.
What is it? I have
four.
Yes, that's the hourglass.
Why are they hard to count?
Because it's a lot.
No, you're not counting these. You're just counting marshmallows.
I just have 2.
All right, it's about 10:15. It is my morning special because today is double special day. Hallelujah. So during this time, I'm going to prep spelling for next week because I do have to give one of my students their list early, so I have to have it ready. Plus, I'm going to grade some vocabulary quizzes that we just took, and I'm going to get stuff ready for science. We are doing the rainbow milk experiment. This is a freebie in my TPT store. If you are interested, I do it every year for St. Patrick's Day, and it's one of my favorites. And set everything up at their tables. That way it saves on time. So each kid already has their printable and all the materials they need. So this is a freebie in my TPT store. I'll put the link down in the description box. It's kind of old, so I know it's a little bit ugly. Sorry, but it gets the trick done. It also comes with some slides that you can project as well. So for materials, all you need is a bowl of milk. I usually put about an inch of milk in the bowl. Now 2% or whole milk works best. I personally use whole milk. Basically, the more fat molecules, the better it will work. They need a little bit of dish soap, a Q-tip, and some food coloring. So basically, all you do is put a few drops of each color of food coloring right in the middle of the milk, and then you're gonna dip the Q-tip into the soap, and you will put it right into the food coloring, and then you will see all the colors swirl around. It is such a fun experiment. My kids every year love it, so I always do it for St. Patrick's Day. I will have the link to this freebie in the description box if you wanna check it out. Go ahead and put your food coloring in the middle, about 5 drops of each color.
Okay. I'll start with red. Because I'm working alone, I'm going to do it all.
Stop, Derek!
Derek, that is not your job. You should not be touching it. Little. I have not given that direction yet. Shark bait. Waterfall.
Okay.
Q-tip person, dip it into the soap, but do not put it in the milk yet.
Wait, not yet. Wait.
Get a lot of soap on it. Remember, when you put it, shark bait. Waterfall. When you put it in, you're going to hold it there. Do not stir it around. Ready? Go.
Hold it in the middle.
Oh my goodness!
Ready? Set?
Go.
Whoa!
That looks like a dot.
No. Explosion.
I know. It is lunchtime. I am actually in a good mood because the morning has not been that bad. However, I had 6 kids absent this morning. Now, 2 did come in late, but I still have 4 kids absent, and there is a huge difference between 23 kids and 19 kids, let me just tell you. This afternoon, I don't have a whole lot going on, which is good. I do need to give a spelling test, and I do need to give a comprehension quiz from the book, That's What Leprechauns Do. I'm gonna do those first thing when we get back. After that, all we have to get done is our leprechaun trap, which is our STEM project, and then ketchup and pickles. I'm a little bit nervous to start doing the leprechaun trap again because there's no real structure. I'm kind of just giving them a bunch of crap and saying, go for it, build a leprechaun trap, have fun, and don't kill each other. All right, it is now 2:15. I just took my class to PE. Afternoon has been rough. Spelling test went well, but then when it came time for me to reread the book and give them the comprehension check, they were awful. And I am just at the point where I'm like, I'm not putting up with it. So I had to show them a little bit of tough love, send them back to their seats to do the comprehension check without finishing the book all the way. And they had to sit with their heads down while I passed out ketchup and pickles papers. Ketchup had to sit there and get started on work right away. If they didn't have anything, they were a pickle, but it had to be silent. And I will say, my classroom has not been that quiet in a really long time. And after about a half an hour of silent ketchup and pickles, I had kids coming up to me, hugging me, and apologizing. So I think it worked. And right before I went to PE, we kind of had to sit down. We all talked about it. I made sure they understood where I was coming from and how I felt. A lot of them apologized, and they did much better on the way to PE. So that is good. Plus, I had 2 more that were dismissed early. So I'm now down to 17 kids, which is absolutely amazing. Thankfully, because it was so quiet during ketchup and pickles, I got a lot of stuff graded. So I don't have a whole lot to do. I have a couple of ketchup and pickles papers left to grade. I have to enter some grades in the grade book. But other than that, I'm pretty much done, which is fantastic because I don't want to be here all night. I do need to stay and get some plans done for next week because I will say I felt so good not having to do plans each night this week. So I definitely want to get some stuff done before I leave, but I don't want to be here super late. So I'm going to go grade some papers, get some stuff done, and I will catch up with you guys after.
Also, here is all of the stuff that I have had to confiscate today. So I guess it is my lucky day after all.
So I'm totally the mean teacher that threw away all of their STEM projects because we did not have a chance to finish them. We were supposed to do it on Thursday, didn't have time, it got pushed to today, and they chose to talk instead, so we didn't do them, and I threw them away. Sorry, not sorry, but I did go through and managed to take out the pieces of cardboard that could still be used in the future, along with the toilet paper tubes, because I don't want to throw them away. I can always use them in the future for STEM projects, so now I'm just trying to figure out somewhere to store all of it. All right, it is now after school. My students left at 3:45. It is now 4:15. I did get caught up talking to people in the hallway, but it's okay because during dismissal, I had kids help me. My room is really clean. It's in good shape. All of my grading is done, so now I just have to focus on lesson plans for next week. And also good news, kind of bad news, but mostly good news. Starting next week, we have to do BASS again. So BASS is the Benchmark Assessment System by Fontes and Pinnell. It is a way to determine student reading levels. We do it in the fall and then again in the spring. I usually hate it because it is a big pain in the butt. You spend like half an hour to an hour on each kid, so it takes a lot of time, and the rest of your kids are just kind of sitting there doing busy work or daily five or something like that. You have to basically read the book one-on-one with them. You check for fluency, you check for accuracy, you time them, and you ask them comprehension questions, and they have to do writing. And sometimes you end up doing a minimum of 3 books per kid, sometimes as many as 5 or 6. So it is very time-consuming. However, that means I do not have to plan guided reading because instead of running guided reading groups, I'm going to be doing BASS testing. So it is kind of a good thing because it's less planning for me to do for about the next month. So I am kind of actually looking forward to it. I'm going to go work on lesson planning and I will catch up with you guys in a bit.
So I have to say I'm really proud of myself because this month I made my Scholastic orders due on March 17th, which is today, and I went ahead and finalized the order. So this time they will actually get here in a normal amount of time.
life update. It is 7 p.m., and while I am done all of my lesson plans for next week, I'm really excited about that, with the exception of small group plans, but it's okay, I can get those done over the weekend. I am not very happy because I just remembered that I have to change over the math homework in my students' math homework folders. I was kind of planning on having a volunteer come today and I was going to have them do it. However, no one ended up coming, which is totally fine. I'm appreciative of the times I do have a volunteer. However, that means that I now have to do it because they have to go home on Monday with the next unit. And I'm totally not prepared to do this at 7 o'clock on Friday, but here I am. It has to get done. Suck it up. Get it done. I will catch up with you guys after. Echoing around these walls, fighting to create a song. I don't want to miss a beat. And on we'll go. Through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. Almost 8 o'clock, and I'm ready to get out of here because I'm absolutely exhausted and ready for the weekend. If you stuck with me to the end of this vlog, thank you, because I know there were a lot of ups and downs, but I always want to be honest with you guys. I always want to show you exactly what I'm going through. Unfortunately, this week that meant being vulnerable, showing emotion. Definitely not my most favorite thing in the world to do. However, I always want to show you guys the reality of what I'm going through so that if you are not a teacher yet, you know what to expect. And if you are a teacher, hopefully you can relate to me in some way. So if you did stick with me and you enjoyed the vlog, despite that, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to me if you haven't already, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end and for supporting my YouTube channel. I appreciate it more than you guys realize. If you want to check out any of my older videos, you can use the two links right down here. And if you want to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any future videos, you can use the link right over here. In the description is the link to all of my social media sites, my Teachers Pay Teacher store, and my Amazon store. And I will catch you guys in my next video.